That's hitting to the rough for mine. Let's have a look at Kevin Kisner. Well, they've found the bunker, but a chance to maybe save from there. Let's return to live play now. Second shot on the second. And here we are with the third shot. Almost went in. It's just about 3 feet away. Fair effort, that. Good birdie. Well, that's certainly a step in the right direction. Keep it going. Lovely momentum for this player after that birdie at the last hole. Keep it rolling.
John, what's going on? Talk to us, Goose.
Down here on hole number four, this is Patrick Cantlay's next shot.
Even for the day. Not a bad spot on the leaderboard. Just outside the top 20. Oh, my God. And that'll be a big boost to his standings on the leaderboard. Let's get back to it, shall we? Second shot here on the third. This would be a great up and down from this spot. If he makes this, he'll save his par. On a great line. Well, hold. Currently one under for the day. Let's see what happens here on the fourth. Opting for the three wood. And he's safely on the green with that shot. Oh, this is a long way from downtown, but you're closer. John, what's he got in front of him?
Well, this one looks like about 26 feet.
That's a good putt to make. We'll take that. And with it, he'll move to a couple under par. And it's worth taking another look at that one. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Teeing off here at the fifth. Looks like they put a good swing on that one. That should find the short stuff.
Luke, unfortunately, that got a horrible kick. Ended up in the rough.
Well, this person displays the power game in pure fashion there.
Using all of his muscles to get that one home in two.
Well, this is exciting. A putt for an eagle. Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it? Oh, this will be good for the momentum. Let's make this birdie putt. Hey, that's a chance. A wonderful putt. You can claim it. Back-to-back birdies.
Got to say, putting this well from this distance is a huge confidence booster.
Trailing by a stroke after that hole. It's time to begin this powerful hole.
That dog will hunt. Let's go to our man, John, on the ground. There's something brewing down there. Let's find out what it is.
Well, I'm on the eighth hole, and we are watching Ian Poulter at the moment.
Okay, let's get back to the action. Already with a couple of wins under their belt. Going with the hybrid. That's not the outcome they were after.
A bit short with that effort.
Getting ready to play their third. Only one shot off the pace. Okay, step one complete, out of the bunker. Now let's go make a putt. And he needs this to save par. Yeah, good putt. Well hold. He's currently tied for third. And the player steps up to this short par four.
Nothing as beautiful as a tiny fade.
Well, Rich, in the thick stuff here, not a good spot to be. not bad. John, do you have any info down there?
Well, guys, I'm here on the eighth hole. This is Patrick Cantlay's next shot.
Sitting at minus one, currently tied for 10th place. A lovely shot into a few feet. And back to the course with the live action. This putt for top spot on the leaderboard, or at least a share of it. That's their fourth birdie. And with that, he'll move to four under par. He finds himself in a share of the lead.
Gotta like it, moving up the leaderboard. Never a bad thing.
And coming off the birdie, they'll be proud of themselves, a chance to keep it rolling. Opting for the 9-iron. That's just inside the range.
Slim chance here for birdie, but you never know.
Gallant attempt. And they'll walk away with a par on this one. And this effort by Kevin Kisner. All right, John, how's this putt looking?
This looks like somewhere in the 27-foot range from here.
Oh, just missed. And after that hole, this is how the leaderboard looks right now. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. Teeing off here at the ninth hole. Not sure if this one will stay on the short grass. Still a chance to attack this hole from the first cut. This putt is for the lead. And racking up their fifth birdie of the day. And that's going to hoist him into first place. Now leading by one shot.
The lead continues to grow. This is simply amazing.
Always love a new beginning. Here we are at the opening hole of the back nine, the 10th. This one's looking good off the tee. That should find the short stuff. Second shot here on the 10th hole. He may be thinking about going for the green here. And here we are with the third shot. Oh, what a shame. That would have been a nice one to hole. This one just outside 7 feet to the hole.
Their short game today has been absolutely sublime, fun to watch.
Oh, what a stroke. Look at him just surging ahead at the top of the leaderboard.
Two in a row there, Luke, getting their groove on.
Still in the lead now after that hole. You've reached the 11th hole, and the tee is yours. This tournament's coming alive. I wonder what just went down. Seems to have chosen the 3-wood. Well, at least it's on the green. That's the positive.
Outside chance of the birdie, but a 2-putt here is still good.
Time to take a look at Ian Poulter from earlier. Don't know about you, Beamer, but I would have loved to have hit a shot of that calibre. Let's get back to it, shall we? This is from miles away. You know what they say, never up, never in. 15 feet to the cup.
Looking better.
Ooh. Putting for bogey. And after that effort, this is how the field is shaping up. And now that finds him in first place. Here we find ourselves on the tee of a par four. Looks like this one's heading safely for the fairway. Let's have a look at Kevin Kisner. Setting up here with a very long putt. Oh, this looks pure. Oh, that's absolutely perfect. Step aside, gents. This man's marching into the top five. Rich, they say you need to have at least one weapon to be a success on tour. But for me, Kevin Kisner has two. Yes, he's a great player, but my God, he's a feisty competitor.
That, I think, is his greatest asset by a long shot. We got a first taste of it a few years back in the playoff loss at the Players' Championship. And going forward, he is week in and week out a force to be reckoned with. He gets any kind of taste of the lead, sniffs the lead, he's not going anywhere. He wants that bad. And he's not gonna make it easy on you. He's not going to make bogeys. He'll par you to death. He will absolutely make you as uncomfortable as he possibly can. He's not long. He's not tall. He's not intimidating. But I got to say, when you look in his eyes, you know that guy is the real deal.
You liked that, didn't you? Scorecard filled with threes never hurts. Good putt to make this. Looking really good, this one. And with that putt, he's bounced back immediately from his previous drop shot. And that will take him to 6 under. Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. To me, the short par four is the most underrated hole in all of golf.
Do you attack it and try and increase your lead, or do you lay back and play safe? I like to attack it. What do they like to do?
That should find the cut stuff. Time for the second shot here at the 13th. This putt to get to 7 under the card. This one has eyes for the hole. And that will drop in for birdie. And with that, he'll move to 7 under. Incredible. Managing to maintain their position on the leaderboard. Par 3s always offer up that hope of a hole in one. Going with the 9-iron, I think. As Tiger would say, wait. Didn't quite strike that as cleanly as they would have hoped.
Airmailed the green with that approach.
You've just got to look with admiration. That shot took some serious skill. You'll take the tap in for par any day. Our man on the ground, John, he's down there. What's the news?
I'm over on the 15th hole now, guys. This is Cantlay's next shot.
Setting up in the bunker here. Oh, you beauty, an eagle.
Little putt shot here. Oh, yes! What a result! Fantastically played.
So after that hole, this is the current standings on the course. Our leader is enjoying a 3-stroke advantage. The honour is yours. Time to hit a good one here at the 15th. This one might just sneak off the fairway. Second shot here on the 15th. Going with a 3-wood here. This one looks to be a tad wayward. Setting up to play the shot here from the greenside rough. Are you kidding me?
What a play from the rough. Was hoping to get on the green and does one better.
What an amazing shot. Let's take another look at that one. Currently 9-under for the round. We've arrived at a par 4 hole.
Standing on this par 4 and leading. What's the strategy? What's going on through their mind? Attack it or lay back? Uh-oh, we're starting to hear roars from another part of the course.
This one might roll into the rough. And let's catch this action from just a moment ago. Ian Poulter with an outstanding shot here.
He's a sharp shooter from short range, isn't he?
Oh, that's the shot. Go ahead and make one. Don't worry about getting it up and down. Okay, let's get back to the action. Sitting at 9-under, currently in the lead. All right, safely out of the bunker, and now a chance to make a putt. This one's for birdie. I like the look of this. And that's the kind of fighting spirit that keeps a good round going.
That a way to grind it out in the bunker, but up and down for the birdie. Nicely done.
And this is quality play, still on top of the leaderboard. And they'd be feeling buoyed with confidence after that birdie. Here's a good chance to maintain the momentum. Opting for the 5-wood. Now that looked pretty good the whole way.
Slim chance for a birdie, but in all reality, 2-putt for par would be just fine.
John, have you got a read on this one?
And this looks like the better part of a 40-footer. Maybe even more. I'm going to go with 42 feet for this one.
Oh, that's a lengthy putt. Well hold.
Going to like it. Two in a row.
Oh, I'd like to have one more look at that shot. Now six shots in front after that hole. Well, it's come down to this, the final hole. Welcome to the 18. No point hanging on to that one. You didn't hit your best there. Well, a man on the ground, John McCarthy, would have a better look at this. How's it lying?
Well, hopefully they can get it out of this first cut. It ended up nestling itself down in there pretty good.
Getting ready to play their third. Lovely touch. Well played.
Yes. Very smooth tempo there on that chip.
And another round safely in the books. And that'll do it. Lovely start to the opening round. In top spot, but there's a whole bunch of people right over their shoulder.
Always good to be out in first place. That means you can afford to make a mistake tomorrow, but you don't want to make too many of them with the chasing back and lurking behind.
I'm Luke Elvey, alongside Rich Beam, and on behalf of all the hard-working folks at HB Studios, it's goodbye for now. Hello and welcome to our PGA Tour coverage here on 2K Sports. Today's coverage of the Greenhill Classic is about to begin. Delighted to have your company for this final round action. I'm Luke Elvey, here alongside Rich Beaman. It's the final round here, Rich. What's our next player up against as they begin it?
Never easy going to bed with the lead, and they're out here today. It's probably weighing on them a little bit. I got to say, though, this player has been playing well. That's why they have the lead. So they have to be excited, and they have to like their chances going into this final round.
Can't wait to find out what happens here. Handy effort, that one. Well, this is some lovely momentum to take into the tournament, coming off a last start win, Rich.
Can't think of any better momentum. Obviously, the player is firing on all cylinders. Sit back, watch, and enjoy it.
Yes, any time you can find the green and have a putt, you'll take it. 14-footer. This one's dialed in. That's very impressive.
Yeah, you gotta love seeing those go in early. Puts you in a good mood for the rest of the day.
Gee, Rich, that's a positive start, isn't it?
Making birdie in the first always puts you in a good frame of mood. It'll be fun to watch the round progress.
Always positive coming off a birdie. Let's see what happens here. Oh, well struck. This drive's heading for the fairway in my eyes. Time for the second shot here on the second hole. Gee, there's some energy and action going on all around this property. Wonder what's happened. Well, that's a tremendous shot and sets up a wonderful opportunity.
Using the big boy muscles to get it home in two there.
Let's head out to the seventh hole.
And from 165 yards.
Opting for the six iron. This player's dialed in. What a shot. And he's holed it. What a shot.
Wow, what can you say? Holing it out from the fairway. Every player loves that feeling. What a shot indeed.
This one's from downtown. Make sure you get the pace right. That wasn't your best effort, was it? Lining up the birdie putt here. Nice stroke. And with that putt hold, it's back-to-back birdies.
Back-to-back birdies moving the right direction there, Luke.
He sits in first position. Here we are at the third. The tee is yours.
This hole is so important at this critical time. Go for it, lay it back. How much do you trust your swing?
Well, this is bold. Their eyes are opening up, headed for the green. Well, that's a pretty good play there, Rich. Right up near the surface. Time for the second shot into the third. Oh, so close. Anytime you can make these putts, they'll certainly add up at the end of the day. Right on 8 feet. This one started out on a good line. And that putt will drop, and he'll extend his lead.
Oh, that settles the nerves right there. Great stuff.
Currently 15 under par for the event.
The play so far has been stellar, increasing the lead, Luke. But can they maintain it? Let's find out.
Opting for the 3-wood. But not a bad approach. He'll be putting.
Slim chance here for birdie, but you never know.
Well, it's time to head back down to the fairways. John, what's up, mate?
I am on the sixth hole now, guys. This is Kevin Kisner.
Certainly makes putting easy if you can chip it that close.
Just eyeballing that one, trying to make it.
Well, this would be a big putt to make. The birdie always nice, but particularly when it's a two. Was on a good line. There's part of about 6 feet coming up. Well, that's a momentum maintainer. Well done. And there's no movement on the leaderboard after that hole. You've arrived at a par five. Remember, a great drive sets up a strong birdie or even eagle opportunity. This looks to be a fairway seeker to me. Already with multiple victories this season. Seems to have chosen the three wood. That's a good looking shot there. Good mid-range putt this one. An 18 footer. Okay, steady now. Be nice to see this one go down. Let's see if they make it. Nice one. Fourth birdie of the day.
That sets a positive tone for the player, doesn't it?
And maintaining top spot on the leaderboard after that. And I don't know if the rest of the field is up for catching them here today in this final round of action. Let's see what happens here on the sixth.